You know when Gabriel, angel Gabriel visited Mary, you will see that verse. He said, the Lord is with you. And this means a lot. This first of all, December, the Lord's Day. Okay. So you see the change of color, royal color, purple there. And this is December, and we celebrate Christmas this month, right? And the incarnation, which means God's taking upon himself humanity and becoming a man. This is an amazing truth, and it is a foundation of our Christian faith. And the Colossians chapter 1, verse 15 says, Jesus is the image of the invisible God. In other words, the invisible God become visible. That is Jesus. And long before this happened, incarnation, the Old Testament, throughout Old Testament, several times, more than right after the fall of Adam and Eve, and then many throughout the prophets, prophecy, long before Jesus' birth, the Old Testament foretold before this thing happened that God would enter the world in human form. And you know what? God chose two special persons. Do you know, can you guess who two special persons?
Jesus' birthday. From this verse, we can imagine
Jesus' birth is either sometime in late May or early June. You know, that's why the shepherd was outside and feeding the sheep, because 6 months is either August or September, because the first month of Jewish is Nisan, which means the first 30 days of spring. It is the same day with our Easter. Easter falls late March or early April. So this 6 months, if it was August, then Jesus' birthday was in May. If it was September, and his birthday is sometime early June. This is just, but we are celebrating Jesus' birth, not birthday. We all celebrate our birthdays, because everybody knows of the birthday. But we are celebrating the birth of Jesus, okay? Now, the second person was Joseph. And since she was engaged, that time, their custom, once they are engaged, just like a marriage. And Joseph heard his fiance is pregnant. And now, Matthew chapter 1, verse 22 starts, verse 20. Okay, I'll read. So we are in the second part, let's read it all together. Joseph was a righteous man. We heard that Joseph, the ruler in Egypt, he was the most patient man and most self-controlled man. Fruit of spirit we went over about his life. This is Jesus' earthly father, Joseph, and he was a righteous man and did not want to expose Mary to public disgrace. He had in mind to divorce her quietly. That time, any virgin, so-called, is pregnant, and they can stone her, and that person will be dead. But didn't work that way, because the God become a human being and went through the Virgin Mary. All right. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give a birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sin." I have these red letters, because what is Jesus' name mean? Save his people from their sin. Okay? Now, if anybody asks you, do you know what means of the name means of Jesus? Then what is your answer? Save his people from their sins. Okay? My name is Chun, and that means believe and trust in goodness. I told you when we talk about the fruit of the Spirit. All right. So let's read all this, the Matthew chapter 22 through 23. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. What does mean the Emmanuel? God with us. Alright. So this is Christmas is the incarnation which God become a man. It is an amazing truth and is the foundation of our faith. So the virgin's prophecy was in Isaiah chapter 7 verse 14. But you have to remember this verse. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. Dr. Chun loves to end the praise in Jesus' name, and also this wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Okay, so let's all read it, and I'll have this verse every Lord's Day in December. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. It is in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. Okay, so remember, Jesus' name means what? Save his people from their sin. What does it mean, Emmanuel? God is with us. So we learned that Emmanuel and four other names. So let's all remember this one. Okay, what is the other four names? Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. All right, let's have a wonderful December, Christmas month. Let's all make a line. Chanyeol.